वेलकम एवरीवन टू आवर न्यू आईओटी ट्यूटोरियल एंड दिस इज़ द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ आवर नोडरेड सीरीज। सो इन दिस पार्ट आई एम गोइंग टू इंटीग्रेट माय एसक्यूएल विद नोडरेड एंड फॉर दैट आई एम यूजिंग रेसबेरी पाई फॉर सेटिंग अप द मॉस्क्यूटो ब्रोकर सो दैट वी कैन रिसीव डेटा फ्रॉम आवर नोड एमसीयू यूजिंग एमक्यूटीटी एंड वी आर ऑल्सो नीड नोडरेड for this is the second client which we are using and we are using the MySQL nodes in that flow and we are also going to set up MySQL's server basically in Raspberry Pi we have to set up the MariaDB server which is available for Raspberry Pi and so let's directly jump to our demo. So you can see here the hardware setup and we have this dashboard, Node-RED dashboard, which in which I am going to show LDR data in the left panel, temperature data in the right panel. For temperature data we have humidity and temperature which is coming from this DHT11 temperature sensor, and for LDR data is the brightness data basically is coming from the LDR sensor, and we are showing this with gauge, and the same is also shown here with chart and gauge. So we have already discussed these UI components of Node-RED, the basically dashboard. Already discussed this dashboard in previous part, so you will please go to the first part of this series and check it out. So we can see that here is our Node-RED flow, and let's first turn on this hardware setup. So I have already uploaded this sketch, and as soon as I turned it on, it will going to connect with my Wi-Fi. As you can see right here, connected. It's now connected, and the data is basically the data are going to send from NodeMCU to the broker on specific topics, on some topics, and NodeMCU/DHT. We will discuss this in the tutorial, and you can see that the data is coming in this dashboard. Fine, you can see right here the data is coming, and the data humidity data 64, gauge brightness is 415, and let's see what is the condition which I have applied, which I have integrated. So the condition is, here is the condition. The condition is that if it is less than 150, then only we will save this data to the database. And threshold, if the threshold will cross, we will give a notification, and all the database operation will be performed. But in case of DHT, the data will be stored in database regularly. So this is the PuTTY, and this is the Raspberry Pi, basically SSH of Raspberry Pi, and let me check how many tables are there in my database name. New is the database name right here. So this is the command show tables. So there is a table DHT and table one is just a test table. So let's focus on DHT. Select star from DHT. You can see that data are coming in the same way as it is. You can match these data. You can check the data, that same data is delivered from here to the database, and it is basically going in every 8 seconds. So the data is publishing every 8 seconds, and its data is storing. So this is the DHT part. This is the DHT part, and it's also visualizing, and we can also visualize this data right here. So let's discuss the LDR part, the brightness part. So let's trigger this notification. So we need to decrease the brightness to 150. Right now it is 404. You can see right here it is 404. So let me decrease it yeah, you can say 104 and we can see a notification. Fine, we can see that notification count is 1. One operation is performed and we can generate a notification, and one data and one row is inserted in our table. And let's see which table is created and what data is inserted. Fine, so tables, let's see that a new table right here, LDR, is created. And what is the data inside it? Select star from LDR 104, and the timing is this time 119.05. This is the time, and basically this is the query. This is the query for getting the count of notifications, the count of rows in that table. So we will discuss these in more detail when I will go for further. For installing Node-RED on Raspberry Pi, you need to update and upgrade, and after that you need to install the build essential tools. And the third step is to simply copy and paste this whole thing in your terminal. And after this thing is totally installed, you will be asked few questions during installation. You need to simply type yes, yes in all the steps. And after the installation is complete, you need to simply how do you log into your dashboard. This is the main step. Like, I am logged in with raspberrypi.local. This is the domain name, basically the local domain assigned to my Raspberry Pi. After and you can also log in with your IP address. So how do you know the IP address of your Raspberry Pi? This is simple. You need to simply type this command, hostname minus capital I, and this is the 169. These are the two IP addresses, and you can use any of these. So I will use the 192.168.1, and this is because I know my router assigned this second IP address and colon the port number 1880 is the default port number for Node-RED, and 1883 is the port number for Mosquito Broker. You can see that I am logged in and we have two flows right now. So before discussing these flows, let's discuss the circuit diagram for this project. We can see that the circuit diagram has a DHT11 temperature sensor, temperature humidity sensor, and this LDR sensor, and it is directly connected to A0 pin, and is the only analog pin of this Node MCU. And this data pin of DHT11 is connected to pin D1 of Node MCU. You can see more clearly now that it is connected to D1 of pin Node MCU, and VCC is connected to the VCC rail of the breadboard, and ground is connected to ground rail in both the cases. And the circuit diagram is very similar to the last tutorial. Talking about the architecture of this project, we have Node-RED and Node MCU connected to our Raspberry Pi, MQTT broker. So these two are the clients. These two are the MQTT clients which are connected to the broker. So these two clients want to exchange some information. So the information can be exchanged via topics. So we have created few topics right in the broker, NodeMCU/LDR, NodeMCU/DHT. And we are directly publishing data from the Node MCU, the data from Node MCU, the LDR data and DHT11 data. And this is subscribed by Node-RED, and Node-RED, we have the SQL in Node-RED, we have the SQL flow. In Node-RED, we have the SQL node, and using that we will easily get this data, get this LDR data, this temperature data, and we will insert it into the DHT table, LDR table, DHT table. And we can also apply conditions. We can also use other commands like query command from this database, like I am using in the case of notification, to query the count of notification. So we can do similar things with use of database. So the structure is quite simple, and let's discuss the same thing with this flow. So you can see that here is basically the MQTT node, MQTT inject node. Basically it will connect to MQTT broker and subscribe to message for a specific topic. So the data which is sent by the Arduino sketch, sent by the Arduino, it is right now sending also. So let's discuss this thing or parallelly. So Node-RED underscore MQTT, we are sending data in the loop part. In the setup part, we are basically connecting to the broker, connecting to the same network first, same network in which our Raspberry Pi is there. So my Raspberry Pi is connected to the router, this, and this PC is also connected to the same router, and the Node MCU is also connected to the same router. All the three devices are connected to same network, and now we can easily access the IP address of the Raspberry Pi, because we all three are in the same network, and Node MCU can easily connect to the Raspberry Pi here. And as soon as it is connected, we are not subscribing any topic for Node MCU, because we don't want to get any data and we only want to send data. So for sending data, we are directly seeing the loop part. You can see that we have used the millis function, and last millis, it is the logic for sending data every 8 seconds. So we can see that the LDR data is read from A0 pin, and it is directly publishing to Node MCU / LDR topic, which we are also shown right here. Publish data is from LDR, it is publishing. So other than that, let's see the sketch. Yeah, so here we have read humidity, read temperature, the DHT library, DHT11 library, DHT.h library is used here for reading the humidity and temperature from DHT11 temperature sensor, and it is directly publishing. If there is no some errors, it's directly publishing to Node MCU / DHT in the form of JSON string right here. It is publishing temperature, humidity, two keys and the values inside it, and the same is also printed in the serial monitor, which you can see here as we are sending data right now. So the data is sending from Node MCU is sent to these topics. Now the second step is to use the Node-RED to subscribe these topics. So these two things are the same, Node-RED / LDR, Node-RED, we are subscribed to these topic, and we can see the connected message. After we deployed, it is showing correct connected message, the broker, and you can edit it and see that the broker is connected to localhost port 1883. This is the IP address of this Raspberry Pi, and it is also connected to the Raspberry Pi port 1883, and there is no username and password required for so you don't need to use username and password for here. And talking about DHT, it is also connected to the same broker and subscribe to the topic. Where is the topic? You need to name the topic here, Node MCU / DHT, quality of service QoS, the 2 is the preferred one, and you can select as per your convenience. And after you get the data, you subscribe the same topic, and you can get this data, the LDR data you are getting it. And what you are doing with this data, you are sending it to a gauge, the UI gauge, which we have already discussed in last session. So if you want to know the UI, the user interface, how I created this, please see the last session. These three things I will discuss in the previous session already. So in this we have a condition, the data which is coming right here in the payload message, in the payload we have data, we have to check the condition, like it is less than 150. If it is less than that, we will do these things. We will save LDR, go for save LDR, in which we can see that we have this SQL queue query. which says create table if not exist LDR. So we are creating a table LDR with the column name brightness of data type varchar 20. So and these two are the columns, brightness and created date time, and we are in the and after a semicolon we have insert into LDR values and curly brace these two values, the value which is the current LDR data and the current timestamp, and we are simply returning the message. So we are doing this SQL query in the message.topic. You can also see that in database in the documentation it is simply written that message.topic must hold the query and you can get the result in message.payload. So we are saving the data, we are saving the query in this, sending the query, and it is fetch going to get this, and that after executing the query it is stored in the database. Fine. So we are also, after this we are making another query, select count star from LDR, which is basically getting the total number of rows from LDR table, total number of rows from LDR table, and this is the query statement, and we are retaining the message. Fine. And this message which we have returned is now the payload is returned in this. So we have to parse the payload in this format to correctly display like this. Fine. So that's all for this video. You can like, share and subscribe for more videos like this, and if you have any idea, join us to collaborate, or if you want to develop any IoT based project, please contact us. Thank you. Thank you.